Obviously, it must be visited on a trip to Athens, as should any number of other famous monuments, museums, and ruins. But from the Acropolis, there's another Athens that comes into view, such as Lycabettus Hill, where the Athenians go to dine and relax and to gaze down on the Acropolis. The other Athens, the less familiar side of Athens, consists as well of sea life, of voyages and excursions from the port of Athens to nearby islands in the Aegean Sea. The other Athens is made up of teeming marketplaces located only steps away from the more famous monuments and ruins. The other Athens is the contemporary Athens, the daily life of a great and fascinating city that lends an entirely new dimension to the experience of travel. And the other Athens consists of beaches, an entire riviera of beaches, all available to you for the cost of a simple bus ride from downtown Athens. We'd like to take you on a new kind of Athens tour, to sites that are not the traditional guidebook attractions, but are the other. There's a new tourist visiting Athens today, and whether he goes on a guided tour or strictly on his own, he uses his spare time to seek out the people of the city and their daily life. From these parks in the center of Athens, he can walk to a subway station, of all things, at Ammonia Square. The fare here, the maximum fare, is 2.5 drachmas or 7.5 cents to the end of the line. And if you'll pay that sum, you'll be taken not to an archaeological site maintained as an exhibition, but to actual digs, where workmen are today engaged in excavating ruins that will provide important new knowledge about the ancient Greek civilization. This is the agora, or marketplace, of ancient Athens. The subway of Athens is at Monastiraki, the present-day market of Athens. And how amazing it is that so few tourists find their way to this bazaar of icons and octopus and of merchants who display all the temperament of the energetic Greeks. Thank you. Not far from the area of craftsmen is the cable car that takes you for 7.5 cents to the top of Lycabettus Hill. And from Lycabettus Hill, you'll have a view of the extremes in tourist living conditions in Athens. The city, young travelers rent space for their sleeping bags on the warm rooftops of friendly apartment houses, while another type of visitor beds down in the glittering Athens Hilton, where he can see fashion shows at lunch. Thousands of visitors come to Athens and never realize that only a short ride away by public bus are the world's most remarkable beaches. On one of your own days in Athens, you'll want to pack a picnic lunch and then board that bus. It costs 18 cents for a trip to the beaches at Phaleron or Vouliagmeni. Once there, another 35 cents will buy you a private locker, a beach chair and umbrella, white sand, and clear, almost transparent waters. Again in Athens, the independent, free-spirited tourist sometimes seeks out the art of ancient Greece in unusual places unvisited by most tourists. The ancient cemetery of Athens, the Keramikos, in the heart of the city, contains sculpture and bas-reliefs dating back to the Mycenaean era. Easter in Athens is a special kind of time when traditional religious ceremonies show you another side of the life of Greece. Here on a church square, one candle lights another until the entire square is illuminated with their glow. But every night in Athens, you'll find color and excitement in the cafe and restaurant life of the city, especially if you seek out the most exotic and the most local of the dining spots, where the atmosphere provides an experience all its own and often at a surprisingly low price. Thank you. wander into tavernas patronized by the residents of the city. They're clustered on the hill of the Ακρόπολης in an area called πλάκα. And soon you'll become a traveler, in the best sense of the term, enjoying a memorable foreign visit. The highlight of any visit to Athens is a trip to one of the nearby Greek islands, such as Aegina, which is only 1.5 hours away. The boats leave from Piraeus, the port of Athens, and you can board any number of them each day without reservations, without specific plans, and simply with a goal of discovery. The relaxed, spontaneous kind of touring will cause you to cast aside some of your familiar habits and routines and enter into a world where everything is new and unexpected. In that kind of atmosphere, and especially in Greece, a man can return to a more fundamental way of life and finally know